Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Vampire, the Masquerade Bloodlines. In the last episode, we arrived to Chinatown, who meant to meet... What was her name again? It doesn't say here anymore, but anyway, the leader of the Kuexin, Ming Shao, Li Ming... I don't remember anymore, but whatever the case, we went to her to ask about Barabus, and the Nosferatu spy who went missing around Chinatown, and then she told us to meet this other guy whom office we just left. I don't remember his name either anymore. And he said we had to save his daughter so that before he could help us. And now he said that we are supposed to go and meet Shao at his warehouse to get more information on the possible whereabouts of Barabus. Wong Hu, that was the guy's name, yeah. So yeah, we are going to that warehouse then, wherever it is. Let's see if I can keep this episode about 30 to 45 minutes long. I have lately been making a bit too long episodes than I would like. I really should watch out for that. So, does it say anything else? At his warehouse. It doesn't really say anything that where the warehouse is. Well, I doubt it's... Oh wait, maybe it's one of those back alley doors around here. Which we ran into when we were exploring the place. Actually... Hello, dude. I'm gonna take some of your blood, thank you very much. Since you were alone and no one was here to see. Almost full. Like here. Could this be the place? Well, I can't even picklock that door, apparently. I should know password though, but I have no idea what it is. Yeah, I thought so. Alright, Alright, then, what about here? Well, we could get inside here. Oh wait, have we been here already? Is this the back of... Oh yeah, it's this place. This is the bathhouse. Oh wait, not bathhouse, the massage... massage place where we rescued Kiki, the daughter of that of the Wong Hu guy. So yeah, so it's not there. He didn't even mention that we would need passwords or anything in order to get inside the warehouse. I think the police saw me here once trying to picklock this thing, and the difficulty is 10 as well. So yeah, we are so not going to picklock that. Oh, can we go up there? Yes, we can. Perhaps the damn sign is in the way, but there is nothing interesting here. Shame. Maybe on the other side then. The white cloud, whatever shop this is. You know what? Let's go have a peek and see what this place is all about. Ah, looks like some sort of Chinese antique shop. Nothing too interesting for us, I take it, but hey, you never know.
There is something in this door for everybody.
Oh, is that so? Yeah.
Everyone gets what they deserve.
What's that supposed to mean? A keychain with a map of California or a cheap plastic Buddha? Yeah, let's say that. Okay, you are one weird old goat, aren't you? Are you fucking with me, old man? You're starting to creep me out. all of those three options are actually rather amusing. You are one old goat, aren't you? Yeah, let's go with that one.
I'm reminded of a story. A thief named Lin was asked to steal an emerald for the head of his gang. The gem belonged to a man in a Hong Kong triad. Most would refuse this danger, but Lin was anxious to do it, and indeed he did.
Is that so? And I just noticed that he has different colored eyes. Jesus Christ, what have you been smoking, man? What the hell is the point of this?
When Lin returned, he did not want to part with the emerald he stole. He felt that the trouble he went through to take it made his ownership legitimate. The man who hired him did not feel the same way, nor did the man he stole it from. Do you know what happened to Lin?
I don't know why, but I actually like this guy's voice acting. It's very pleasant to listen to. He sold the emerald, made a lot of money, and bought a network. I don't know. Dead? Are you Lin? Are you Lin?
No.
Well, damn.
Lin was caught. One man has his gem back, but Lin's employer has nothing. I'd heard this tale from him when he visited my store. Sadly, I had nothing to sell him.
Is there a point to this? So? Goddamn, why the hell does everyone tell me all this useless shit? Yeah, let's go with that one.
My mistake. I thought it was a tale you might be interested in. Please let me know if anything catches the eyes.
Well, where you going somewhere with that pointless story?
Lin's eyes wanted more than his hands could keep. Ambitious eyes are, sadly, not for sale here at the moment. Though I do have a buyer interested. Do you know when the next eye harvest is, by chance?
What? Eye harvest? Left my farmer's almanac in my other pants. Sorry. Eye harvest?
Lin's body is being kept in a freezer in the back of a local noodle shop, I hear. There are people there who want him intact. But I think his eyes would fill my shelf nicely if they were to wander in. I gouge hell. A fitting punishment for Lin.
That's sick. I'll get them. Eyes. Never stole eyes before. Always the first time. That's sick. I'll get them. Let's go with the second option.
I knew you would. What other reason to waste words on the ill-fated?
Alright, so... I'm looking for someone. Real ugly, snooping type. Seen anyone like that?
No.
that quick hand movement he made. You sell weapons? He doesn't look like it, though. But then again, the herb seller was selling katanas and weapons and all gear and all that shit, so who knows?
I sell things many would find cruel, but weapons? No.
Then I'm out of here. Alright, so let's see. Mr. Ox wants you to harvest Lin's eyes for him. His body is being kept in a freezer in the back of a local noodle shop. Alright, well, I guess we can do this one real quick. And besides, it's not like we know where the warehouse is anyway, so might as well do this. Maybe we'll find a warehouse as well while we're at it. Alright, so back of a local noodle shop. Noodle shop, and at the back of it. Let's see. Kamikaze Zen. It doesn't sound like a noodle shop. Mail Express. What's this? I don't know. Oh, I think this actually might be the noodle shop. It kind of looks like it. So, is it somewhere here in the back? Oh, it's open. All right. Wait, wasn't that the door that had like a 10 pick lock difficulty? I don't know. But that's the freezer, I take it. It seems to be locked, but I don't know. Let's, before we try anything, let's try this. Eyeballs. Eyeballs? Yeah. Well, we got them. Well, that was relatively easy so far. What did the quest box say? You have harvested Lin's eyes for Mr. Ox. Now return to them. Alright. Then, again. Well, this was surprisingly easy, actually. Not that I mind, but yeah, this was a pleasant surprise. I don't think we have done any other quest in this game and this fast. Well, here's your damn eyeballs.
You are always welcome here.
You're damn right I am. Here are the eyes.
Yes. They stare ambitiously. Hello, Lin. Do you like it there? These are an excellent addition to my shop. Here, please accept this as a fair trade. I have another task, if it piques your curiosity.
Well, I guess I can always listen. Let's hear it.
I need you to be a bad luck farmer. Do you know what this is?
Well, I'm not sure, but I don't exactly like the sound of that. A poor translation.
A customer has bought an unlucky talisman from me and wishes it delivered to an enemy of theirs. I need you to place this in the locker of a patron at the Lotus Blossom Massage Parlor so that the bad luck can bloom.
Oh, we have already been in Lotus Blossom Massage Parlor, alright. That's all. Well, okay, I do it. Might as well.
My customer has placed a black circle on his enemy's locker. Plant the talisman. Bad luck, farmer.
That mouth movement. Sure, whatever, I'll see what I can do. Well, as long as you're paying me, I'll put up with you later. All right, so we got another good quest, which also sounds very easy. Plus, we have already been to that massage parlor already, so everyone there should be dead. So this shouldn't take very long. But then again, if they're all dead, then does this really have any purpose whatsoever anymore? Well, whatever. As long as I get some free experience points or money or something, I don't care. So a locker room. And they still haven't cleaned up this place. So a locker room with a... What does it say again? You are to place a bad luck talisman in a locker in the Lotus Blossom. The locker will have a black circle around it. Oh yeah, it's there, alright. Well, first we need to go to the other side of the building. And then, was it downstairs? No, not here. Not here. I'm quite sure it was downstairs. Well, whatever. Maybe there. And here. Yeah, around here. And I do it. Don't mind me. Yeah, here. Oh, there we go. Alright, so where is this a talisman? Bad luck talisman. A talisman that Mr. Ox asked you to put in a marked locker at the Lotus Blossom. Alright.
Hey! What the hell you think you're doing? That's my locker, hooker!
Did you just call me a hooker, you big fat ass? Oh, you are so fucking dead now. If you value your life, turn around and walk away.
Huh? Oh yeah? I'm crazy, hooker! I'll kill you! I don't care!
Damn it! Now you have pissed me off! Arrgh! What? What? Wait, what? I did not do that. Well, I did, but I didn't do it on purpose. I just went to frenzy for absolutely no reason. What the f... Well, my humanity is not the highest possible, but still. I had no control over that whatsoever. What does your quest log say anyway? You have successfully placed a bad luck talisman. Alright, well, I guess we can just leave them. Man, I wish I could open these chests, but no, apparently I can't. Alright. Well, whatever. Let's just hope that we don't go to the frenzy mode and kill all these poor people here in public. That would be terrible. Oh wait, not this way. It's this way. Here. Yeah, but yeah, that was very weird. Maybe that was supposed to happen in this quest, so that it was scripted and planned and everything. Possibly, I don't know.
You are always welcome here.
About that talisman.
Did the seed take root?
The guy saw me. He attacked me, and I killed him.
That is assuredly bad luck for him. The cost to my customer was quite high. They will be pleased to hear this. As before, accept this with my gratitude.
Well, thanks. Anything else you need me to do? You knew this was going to happen?
If you can't make a man walk into hell, make the demons come to him.
Point made. Goodbye. You are twisted. Lucky for you, I don't stoop to your level. How relevant you bring up hell? That's where I'm sending you right now. Well, I don't really care. But then again, I don't know what you are, old man, but I'll let you live for now. Yeah, I think this is good enough. Alright, so we have completed those quests, but did we get any items or did we just... What's this? Heart of Eliza. This glassy stone appears to have a liquid core. The stone itself is milky and translucent, rock solid, and unlike anything you have seen. Possession of the Heart of Eliza conveys a melee bonus of 1. Alright, so we deal more damage with melee attacks or something? Well, it's good regardless. And what's this? Antique locket. This locket is old and slightly tarnished. It might be your imagination, but it seems to radiate an unnatural heat, which quickens your fingers. Wearing it increases your security skill by 1. Alright, cool. Oh yeah, this is a Pearl of Dubai that we got from Isaac. Was it in the last episode or the one before that? I don't remember, but anyway. This jewel is the famous Pearl of Dubai. It's very precious and full of magical vibrancy that gives you a boost to your charisma. But not enough charisma for us to be able to hit on chicks, I'm afraid. Alright now. But the damn warehouse. If we find a warehouse, then I think that's a good place to end the episode. Kamikaze Zen. Could it be possibly this place? Well, we can't get in there, so I guess not. It's not that. That's a restaurant. what's this? Oh, it's nothing. We can't even enter inside. All right, Jenks, that's the gun smuggler, pretending to be an herb salesman. Now, what was this? That's nothing either. Now we can't get there. Nothing here either. It really doesn't say where we have to go. You are to meet with Zhao at his warehouse to get more information on the possible whereabouts of Barabus. Alright, so where the hell is this warehouse? I assume it's somewhere around here. Anything here? No. Well, maybe it's somewhere outside of Chinatown. Fu Syndicate. Uh-huh. Well, I'm quite sure it's not this either. Can I even go in? Yes, I can, but let's not go in there. Not sure where we have to go, folks. That's a dead end, isn't it? No. Nothing here. Shao's Imports. Oh, there we go. That's a warehouse, all right. All right, I guess let's find Zhao and see what he has to say, and then I guess we can end the episode for today. I'm getting some flashbacks from this place. Is he here?
I do. Longhaul called. You're looking for someone.
Yeah, that's right.
I don't know where your friend is, but I know the Tong are involved. The leader of the Tong, Johnny, he'll know where they are.
And wait, of course we have to find someone else. And where do I find Johnny? I'm sure he would love to tell me about it, right?
Johnny's at Glaze. It's his club. You'll need a password to enter.
Oh, it's that place.
The password is 725. There will be Tong everywhere. Johnny's office is upstairs.
Thanks. Why are you helping me? Well, I don't really care why he's helping. The fact is that he's helping, and that's the main thing. You have just made my life a whole lot easier. So what? 20, 30 Tong inside? I like where this is headed.
I am a man of my word, and I owe the debt to Wong Ho. By paying that debt, I have made an enemy of the Tong who I once belonged to.
What are you going to do now? Well, thanks for your help. Looks like you really pissed them off.
You should leave now.
We know it was you.
Oh shit. Do you need some help with them? You know what happened. Oh,
excuse me.
All right. Oh shit. Shit. I need to... Oh, fuck me. Alright. That wasn't a very good idea after all. Damn it. Alright. This time we are going to get them. And before that, I'm also going to use blood heal. Oh, fuck. Jesus Christ. And this time I'm going to use blood heal as well. Oh. I didn't want to use that thing again. The spell, I mean. Oh shit. Let's just wait till he comes here. This is more like it. Come here. Oh, and stop. and stop crawling. This whole fight reminds me of a John Woo movie. Oh shit. Oh fuck, we are at frenzy. Heal? Well, fuck, we are so fucked. I only got blue blood pack. I don't like to use it, but I guess we are kinda have to. Come here. Stand up. And we got a knife. Nice. There are still at least two, three, at least one somewhere upstairs, if I'm not mistaken. Ouch. Ouch, that hurts. God damn it, this. Oh! Fuck! I was just about to suck him dry. Alright, new strategy. This game is so loud. So, new strategy. I'm just going to wait till they all come here one by one and then I kill them. So, are they coming? Oh, okay, they are not coming. I can't use this computer or anything, can I? No. Any... could I just throw these on them? That would be kind of hilarious. So maybe it's actually quite a suicidal to just go there and try to kill them all. Maybe I should just try to be more sneaky and leave this way. But then again, I do want to kill them. They have already killed me twice already. Maybe I should like jump from up here. Right on top of them. That might be a good plan. Alright, where's the other one? There were supposed to be two down here, right? Hey. Oh, fuck. Come here. Let's try to be a bit more sneaky this time. Fuck. Come on. Fuck. Fuck! This episode is going to be too long again because of these assholes. Oh fuck! Fuck! Jesus Christ! All right, this time let's just wait till they come here. They must be coming here at some point, right? Since they know that I'm here. They sure are taking their sweet ass time, though. Oh, there they come. Oh, they killed they shot their own friend. That's fine by me. Come on, come in. I'm like a sitting duck here. Alright, can't you see that you can't shoot me from there? Just come inside already. There we go. What? He didn't die? Oh fuck. Come on. He's dead. Oh, katana. We're gonna take that bad boy. Not sure how powerful that katana is. And plus, we are much more efficient with unarmed combat anyway, but... Hey, it's cool that we have it. Might as well give it a try. Look at us, we are so fucking badass. How they come in here? Oh fuck, Jesus Christ. Don't tell me that they are just going to stay there. Come on, come up. You won't get me otherwise. Jeez. Can I even go there? Oh! Damn! I like this! Oh, fuck! Fuck! Run, run. Quickly, inside. And I need some health back. And he's dead. Damn, I like this weapon. Now, is there like only two left? Because I want to kill one of them, and then I go and suck the other one dry. There we go. Oh wait, is he dead? No, not quite. Maybe I should use this Well, this gun is not doing shit. It's not doing almost anything. Oh, alright, now we can suck him dry. Come here. There we go. Suck him dry. There we go. Hey you! What, there's more? Fuck. Fuck, 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 fuck. Fuck! These guys are really starting to piss me off. So far so good. Now if only they would come up here, one by one. Oh shit, they gave up. Or at least two of them left. Come on, up here. Some ammo, always nice. Maybe I should just shoot them a little bit. Maybe that will get their attention. Hmm? Oh shit. Jesus Christ, I'm terrible with this gun. The aim just keeps bouncing up and down like this. And I'm not even moving my mouse. Well, at least I can do some damage, like this. Did I kill one of them? Just a few more shots. If only I had a sniper rifle of some kind, that would be so nice right now. There we go. That's two dead. Well, all right. I guess I didn't kill one of them. One of them earlier. It just sounded like I did. Jesus! How'd they come in here? No, they are not. What other guns do I have? I don't know, maybe this will help me. Oh, I didn't want to use it. Come on, die. Shit. Luckily, we got fuck tons of ammo. Alright, that's one. Now there's one more left. I think I'm just gonna go and suck him dry. Alright, come here. Come here. Alright, I know that there is more assholes behind this door. But where's the katana we got last time? Where is it? I want it. Holy shit, this guy had lots of blood. Fuck. Jesus Christ, they hurt. That's how many more are they? Holy shit. There's a whole army of them. Well, he's coming. Thank God for blood heal. Alright, are you coming in? Come on. Maybe I should try shotgun. Oh wait, do I even... I don't even have any shots. Well, fuck. Guess we have to go with this. Did he die? I did not see him. Die. There we go. And let's get some health back as well with blood heal. There we go. They are dying one by one. Shit! Fuck! I was too panicked to switch to melee. Well, there's that lonely guy. We should take him out. Well, like, oh fuck! I didn't want to push him away. Oh shit! Fuck! Fuck, punch them! Let's heal a little bit. He has a katana. I want it. Give it to me. There we go. Alright. Now we're not fucking around anymore. You know what, I'm gonna save this game real fast here. Okie dokie. Now, let's see. There's only one guy over there. And he can't shoot me from there now. And is he the only one? No, there's that guy over there. But maybe I can suck that guy dry over here. Possibly, but he might see me. I really could use some more blood. Don't group up together. Maybe... can I get a stealth kill? That would be fabulous. What? Actually, I actually forgot how to do it. Well, whatever. Wow, this guy doesn't have as much blood as the last one we sucked dry, but this is good enough. Oh, fuck. Run. Ah, there's so fucking many of them that this isn't even funny. Oh, fuck. Well, fuck. One down, that's something. Slice and dice them. Cut them in half. Fuck, I love this weapon. And then we're gonna suck... like I was saying, we're gonna suck you dry. Jesus Christ, you gave me so much fucking trouble. Ah, alright, then might as well pick up all this ammo. Why aren't you picking it up? Maybe you are full on ammo. Alright. Now let's see if this is there anything else we can pick up. Am I really full on ammo for that thing? Let's reload and well, I guess we are full of it now. Well, whatever. But I like this samurai sword a lot. Alright, now let's get out of here, and I'm gonna end this episode here, finally. And this is why these episodes last way too long than I would want to. Now, before we quit, what does the quest log say? You need to get to Johnny in his office upstairs at the Glass and Nightclub to get information on the whereabouts of Parables. The password to enter Glaze is 725, and you better do this without a big commotion. Something tells me that that's not going to happen, but hey, we'll see. But yeah, we are going to go to that club in the next episode and perhaps finally find out where Barabus is. So, thank you for watching once again, and see you next time for more Vampire: The Masquerade Bloodlines.